Let's take someone with a random account, with a random name that just seems attractive.
Play live online against the world's top chess players while they stream their thoughts live. As a Chess24 Premium member, seize the chance to have your moment of fame. Get a peek inside their lives with question and answer sessions, in-depth teaching, analysis and interviews. The Champions Chess Tour, with countless accompanying events, is happening now. Tune in on Chess24.
Hello everyone. Today I have an honor to play yet another banter. So let's keep the talking and start playing. So now it's about to transpose to Nimce Indian defense. And this particular variation is very demanding for both sides, but I think it's easy to get in trouble with white here. The opponent seems to know what he's doing. I can take on d5, but I don't really want to undouble his pawns. I'm considering e5. But perhaps knight d7 first would be better. Then there is this de fe knight d4 tactics. Okay, let's play e5, just to be sure. Now I assume knight h4, e4, f4 is the idea for him. Okay, rook e1. Let's develop normally. After e4, knight c5 is unpleasant. Because I might want to take this bishop after knight d2, knight d3, but now I think he just blundered a pawn. Now, obviously, my position is a dream. Pawn up and also positionally better. Good knight against a bad bishop scenario as well. So now the E-line is getting open, and I'm much better prepared to eat some. It's very bad for white. Can take d as well. And queen e5 looks good as well. Yeah, let's trade queens. Just creating the pass pawn is the simplest way to convert my advantage. This is an interesting line for black, because knight d7 is played with aim of e5, and the only way white can counter it is to play d4. But then bishop on g2 is not so great. Usually white prefers to have his pawn on d3, so that he can play e4 or c4. Now it's some sort of King's Indian attack, probably. Not sure if I want to go a5 here. a5, f4. Not sure. Yeah, the only thing I have to recon it is the move d4. When, for example, I play b5, bishop b7, or something like this, then d4 might be unpleasant, but might be also not so threatening. So actually, it's not clear. Yeah, let's play knight f8 with the idea of d4. Not sure it's that great for black, but at least I'm gaining space. Here even bishop takes d4 is possible, but probably it doesn't make that much sense for him. Because after e5, I can basically play whatever, even bishop takes d5. Yeah, but now I'm happy, because I have a plan of playing b6, a6, and b5. And it's also difficult for him to play f4. Perhaps I can save a tempo somehow and just go a6, b5. Obviously, after a6, there is a5, so there is bishop e6, after a5, queen d2. Well, it doesn't make sense for me, I think so. Yeah, let's play rook b8 first, because if I start with b6, then f4 might be unpleasant, and after e takes e5, my rook would be hanging on a8. Okay, bishop c1 is a good move. Let's play this b6 anyway. Now after f4, I just want to take ef, gf, possibly knight g6. After that, or even knight takes e4. If it works. Not sure of this queen e1 move. I mean, he wants to defend his knight after f4, ef, gf, but perhaps it's too slow. Can play bishop a5 here. And I will start with knight g6 so that f4 is not a threat anymore. And only after knight f5, bishop a5. Let's grab the open line. Now it's very difficult for him to play because if we can't play f4, then suddenly there is no plan for him, and it's very difficult to play without a plan, especially in such close positions. Okay, what I'm supposed to do now? I think I will aim to go c4. He wants h5. Okay, so let's play knight e7 first, just to expel his knight. Yeah, and now knight g6 back makes sense. Probably it's too sophisticated, so we'll just play bishop e6. But maybe it wasn't. It wasn't that bad idea to play this knight g6. Okay, I have to hurry up because it's without increment. Obviously, it's a bit random at this stage. That was a bad idea for him, I think, but maybe it wasn't. Yeah, I'm going to lose some time. Yeah, obviously not a very pleasing way to finish the game, but such things happens when you play without the increments. Let's play the Benko. Yeah, so there is no Benko at all. Now it's just a transposition to c4, c5 line, the English opening. But knight xc6 is not so great, I think, for him. I usually play like this after, let's say, knight c3, e6, and then e4, bishop b4, knight c6. The point is that black has played e6, and yeah, there is no Fiorcento available. Yeah, now it's probably quite bad for white already, because knight e4 is a threat. I guess he has to take on f6, but then I have two bishops. Okay, this is a blunder, obviously. Let's play for a mate here. Let's play. Let's make it safe and play d3 just to avoid the open variation and many others. In this move order, knight c3 is of course possible because there is no knight a5 due to the fact that the pawn e5 would be hanging. The very line is obviously very popular. It has been a topic of the Kariaki and Carson match. Now there is a question if I'm supposed to take on e7 or play knight f4. I think I will go for the latter. Yeah, I think that white has a tiny edge here because bishop on b3 is slightly better than bishop on e7. But obviously it's not that much. Perhaps g3 is the idea. Play h4 and to limit his bishop even more. Now I think a4 makes sense because there is no knight c5. Yeah, so he wants to play c4 and rock my bishop in. Yeah, perhaps bishop d5 here is a move. Obviously, I would prefer to have this position without knights. But after knight d5, there was c4 as set, and that would be pretty awkward to meet. No. The pawn on h3 might be hanging. So king g2 makes sense to me. Just to protect everything in advance. Okay, g5 is probably a bad move here, because it looks quite anti-positional. I think his idea is to take on d5, but after e d, his king is very seriously weakened. Queen f6 is already a threat here. And also I can play it slowly. Rook e1, double on the e-line, for example. Yeah, queen f6, I think is game over. Yeah, that positions are very tricky for black, because apparently there is nothing threatening in this kind of positions, but when it's slightly more active and it's easier to play for him. I'm not sure of the line. I have just played, just want to get rid of the Fiori. Obviously, this is the line. Now e3 and e4, I think. The two main moves. c3 also makes sense. Let's play knight a6. Now I can choose between rook b8 and knight c7. Rook b8 looks a bit more active to me, so. Now there is a question how I'm supposed to develop my pieces. I can play g6, of course. Also g5 might be interesting. But I don't like to allow him to play e5. It might be not so great, but d6. d6 is also possible, but it might be too slow. After a4, for example, before bishop b5 is very unpleasant. And the third option of going e6 doesn't look like very appealing to me either, because there is e5, g6, and d6. Yeah, so let's try to create a mess here. After a5, I think I will just play queen g7. Or maybe queen g6. Got to play g4 here. Yeah, but I'm not sure of this for him, because after a queen h1 or queen h2, he gets king f1, but let's play queen h1, after king 1 g3, because the pawn would be lost anyway. Now there is, for example, bishop h6 possible, with the idea of bishop e3. It might be quite tricky for him. The problem is that after c4, there is queen d4, so I think bishop e3 makes sense, and probably queen h6 here. Yeah, now I wanna play c4 and knight c5. Okay, let's play e6 or d6, I'm not sure. Maybe e6, just not to allow this knight f5. I don't like the way he played, to be honest. Like, I'm very active now. These pieces are a bit clumsy. I can take on h4. I'm not sure I really want to do this. Well, at least I'm pretending I'm threatening something. So rook b6 makes sense, because there might be some ideas of rook lift along the 6th rank. Let's play like this. So he got rid of this annoying knight, but now I have a material advantage, and that should be enough to convert. Let's take first. It doesn't make that much sense what I have played, but still. Oh, my blunder, knight c7, obviously. Could have inserted a bishop f1 check. Yeah, but now it's again just time scramble. And now I'm just winning. Yes, the game was very complicated, but I think he misplayed with the slow moves like bishop f3 and knight d2. Because it should be better for white. He was more developed than me, so yeah, but something went wrong for him. No Spanish against the Spanish this time. So now the main battleground of the King's Indian defense. Let's play the bayonet attack. Yeah, there are many moves to choose from. Play rook e1 or g3. Let's play g3. Yeah, now I think knight g5 and bishop e3 is the line. Let's play it. Maybe after knight f6 f3 also, I think, but let's play bishop f3. I think Vladimir Kramnik played like this. The idea is obviously to jump on e6. After h6, knight e6. But now it looks like a safe edge for white, because it's very difficult for him to attack. Good grip on the king side, and we'll just stream on the queen side. You can play c5 immediately. Knight f3 also makes sense. So does knight e6. Maybe knight f3. Just not allowing him to jump on d4. Okay, f5. Obviously makes sense. I would just play bishop d2, I think. Bishop a3 would be probably the same. Now time for a4, a5. Okay, a5. As said, I think it's at least slightly better for white here, because I have an easy play on the queen side, while he hasn't any on the king side. Knight d4. Oh, I would love to play c5. I can do it straight away. Yeah, but I think it's unnecessary and only complicate. Only complicating the position, so we'll just play it slow. Let's play Queen c2. But queen e7 is unpleasant, because I missed that after bishop d3, bishop d2, there is d3. Yeah, and that's very bad. So I have to play bishop b4 first to allow these tactics, and now probably bishop d2. You can play rook b1, we'll first play h4. And after queen b3, maybe rook b1 now. Okay, let's play it. The bishop should be the endgame. The bishop endgame should be slightly better for me, but what bishop a4? It's a blunder. I don't know. Let's try to checkmate him. Ah, so this bishop a4 was very unfortunate. There was some calculation error, I guess. Okay, so he probably wants to play close Sicilian, but also can play d4 whenever he wishes. Let's play normally with g6, bishop g7. I guess d4 now. Usually in these setups, white prefers to have his knight on e2, because then it's easier to attack with f4, g4, and so on. I'm not sure of the attack with knight on f3. Let's play f5, a4. I'm not sure what is it for, but g4. Now I think e5 looks good for me when I have traded. No, actually, he has traded dark square bishops. I think my knight on f6 is pretty limited piece here. And I have to recon with c3 and d4. Idea, so I will play a3 first just to stop this, and now I can play either knight c7, knight a6, or knight c7, knight b5. g5 can be played. I'm not sure about it, however, because knight f5 and then h4. Yeah, maybe queen h4 is also the move. I think I will just play knight c7. Yeah, knight b5. Allowing him to play f5 is a very risky strategy. After f6, now he has h4 and g5. I'm not sure of this capturing on g6 ball. Knight d4 maybe. Well, this looks great for me. Of course not training knights, because my knight is much better than his. Yeah, knight f4 is the idea, and there is no attack making whatsoever. Now I am positionally better on both wings. I can take on h3, but I won't. He allows me to play c4, so let's play it. After d4, I can just play rook bc6 or maybe e4. That makes sense as well. Let's play d5 just to close all the lines in the center. Can take on h4. I think I will. Yeah, and rook c2. Maybe rook c1. However, now rook h4 is possible, but after rook h4 I can still play rook c2, not allowing him any counterplay on the h-line. Yeah, but it's without increment, I think, so that's bad. Of course, winning this positionary here, but it might be a bit difficult to convert on time. Yeah, now I'm going after a2. Oh, I didn't see king e1. I thought I was winning, but obviously this is winning as well. So that was an interesting game. Actually, I think f takes g6 was a very bad move by him, because if he had played h4 instead, then he could have got a very strong attack. Obviously, I probably shouldn't have allowed him to do that, to play f5. Time to play the Slav defense. Bishop e2. The main move is bishop d3, but of course bishop e2 is a very challenging line as well. 45 is the main line here. No, knight d4 or knight h4 are the moves. Bishop g3 is the move, but after h takes g3, queen takes d4, queen d1 is a strong response, and that's endgame. White has very good compensation for the missing pawn. I play bishop c5 instead. One of these lines were bad for black. I don't really remember right now. Queen b6. Takes on g4. That is b4, I think. After bishop takes g4, knight takes g4. Yeah, it's probably not so great for me. Because after b4, bishop takes b4, there is queen b2. And I have to take on c3. Due to lead problem on g7. After queen takes c3. There is still a threat of checkmate, and bishop a3, bishop c5 is on the agenda as well. But if he doesn't play b4 here, it's very fine for black. Okay, so he hasn't found it. I think knight e5 makes perfect sense here. Maybe rook e8, maybe. Maybe knight g6. Rook e8. Takes, knight e5, queen g4. I think g6. Knight h6, check, king g7. It's very messy, it might be. Actually, very dangerous for me. Yeah, probably it was better not to allow this, because I can't play bishop f8 here because of knight h6 check. So g6 is forced. I mean, I can take on f5, but then I'm without the exchange. Yeah, knight h6, king g7, queen f4. Rook e7, knight g4 is very dangerous. I think I have to play bishop d4 in that variation after knight g4. It's the only move, because I want to play c5 and I'm defending the f6 square. Okay, knight f5, I can repeat the position once. I can play king h8, but after knight h6, I'm not sure. Yeah, but rook f8 is the move there. King f8 is also... No, king f8 is not possible because of queen f4. Okay, so now I can play f6. And I think I will... There are some tricks, but rook d1 is, no, it can be working for him. Just rook e7, for example, yeah, looks good to me. Rook f8, just to defend everything. Then takes, rook e7 is not very pleasant. Mm-hmm. And after rook e8, when I play rook e8, then queen takes f5. The pawn on f6 is hanging. Okay, let's play this rook f8. Okay, queen f5 is huge. I mean, quite a huge mistake because of bishop c8. And my useless bishop at the moment is getting exchanged for the powerful rook. What has just happened? Did I disconnect or? No, but I won the game, so I'm not sure. Yeah, it told me I was disconnected and I was about to lose the game in 30 seconds, but then the move queen takes f6 appeared and I won, so. I'm not sure. So the Nimitz are in the defense with queen c2. Yeah, now k3 is not among the most pure choices in the position. C takes d5 and a3 are two main moves. Now I can play b6. Yeah, I will play b6. Now the standard idea is to play bishop b7 and try to play knight e4. Cd, I expect. Okay, knight e5. So my opponent is very aggressively minded. Because he wants to get an attack. If I take on g2, I think I will accept the challenge because I have bishop e4 response. Now I assume queen b3. After queen b3, I can play c5, trying to open, I mean, to get to his king. So knight d7 looks good to try his wonderful knight. He has some compensation, but I think it's not enough because his king is still in the center and there is no real attack yet. Yeah, maybe knight d5 now. Yeah, but probably c5 makes the most sense. After c5, bishop d2, bishop takes c3, bishop takes c3, his bishop is getting into the play, so I will play knight d5 instead. Let's give a check to disturb his coordination. Okay, first I going to take here because I'm not sure if I really wanna take on e5, but you can't avoid taking on c3. Yeah, but I think it trading dances. Makes sense because it's simplifying a position and getting rid of his active pieces. And now c5, opening the center. The important point is that rook g4 doesn't work because of queen takes g4. Okay, so king d2, renewing a threat. Let's play queen h6 maybe. Yeah, rook d8 looks good to me. Now knight takes c3 might be on the agenda. But I think g6 first is more practical. And now knight takes c3 looks crushing. So that was an interesting idea in the opening. Yeah, but I'm not sure. Probably it was not really working for him. But anyway, an interesting idea. Let's play the Ninzo Indian from the white side now. This is some theory I don't really know. Now e4 is the move, but actually for I guess e5 is the response, so let's play knight g3, just developing the pieces. Should be two. Now I would love to play f4 and c5 to limit his activity as much as possible. But I think it can be done. Because after c5 he would obviously go e5 and after f4 d takes c4. Might have been an issue. Let's just take on e5. Bishop b2. It's probably not much for white here, but at least there are many pieces and a lot of play ahead. Can play knight f5, but he will just go queen f8. Let's play rook d1. Because after bishop e6, then knight f5 would be more to the point, because after queen f8 there is knight d4, and I'm threatening to capture his bishop. Still, he's got bishop c4 after that, but at least it would be more threatening for him. Knight g4. H3 is obviously not possible because of knight takes e3. And how I'm supposed to deal with it. Threats. I'm not sure. Okay, let's play rook e1. It's very, very passive and very risky actually, because yeah, probably knight takes f2 is. Yeah, it's probably just winning for black because I missed bishop b6 in the end of the variation. Yeah, but he didn't see it either, so now knight f1. It's very passive and likely there was nothing better for white, but I couldn't quite see. Now at least I'm aiming to play h3. After knight h6, I think I will play e4 to allow him to play knight f5. Obviously, knight e5 is the move. Yeah, knight h6 e4, I think it's pretty a strong response. Knight d2 maybe. Some knight c4, knight f3 might be the idea. Where to? Okay, to f3. Yeah, not sure of this, but I have to play it. Obviously, the g4 move is very controversial, at least, but I have to do something quick. Yeah, I'm probably gonna get flagged. Yeah, okay, so that was an interesting game, and yeah, I think I erred terribly with this rook e1 move. My opponent didn't spot the occasion. Let's play the Pierce. This is interesting combination of plans because usually white doesn't play like bishop d3 and bishop g5. Maybe knight c6, threat, potentially threatening knight takes d4. Yeah, now my opponent has disconnected. Okay, queen d2. You can play g5. Okay, let's play g5. With the idea of going knight g4 after bishop e3. The important point is that h4 wasn't opening the king side because there was bishop knight takes e3 and g4. Yeah, and now I should be pretty comfortable with two bishops. Let's play a6 as well. After long castle, there is b5, b5, b4 plan. Now my opponent just blunder pawn. I'm supposed to play here. Maybe knight c6. Because his pieces are a bit clumsy at the moment, and my knight has wonderful perspectives. Yeah, c4, c3, b4. Let's play c4. I was still holding after b takes c3, queen a5, knight b1. Yeah, now I've got a dream position. Rook d3 is just making things quicker. After queen f4, there is e5, and actually the queen is trapped. That's quite something to trap the queen on f4. I think I have never seen actually trapping the queen on f4. Pretty nice to have the opportunity to do so. Fide Arena GM, that's an interesting nick. Let's play e5 this time. H3 is a mistake because after knight a5, there I'm just getting the right square bishop for free. And it's very comfortable for black. Still, it might be not so terrible for white, objectively, but yeah, should be very easy to play with black. Now I can take on e4 or de first, or maybe de. Let's play fancy and go bishop c5 now. The bishop looks very good on the diagonal, but they are allowing bishop g5. Was about to say that. Bishop e3 was also interesting. Instead of bishop h4. The move queen e6, I'm unpinning my knight and can go either to h5 or d7. Or maybe h5. Let's just play f6 to block his bishop. The move is obviously weakening my king a bit. But it's difficult to believe at the moment that I might have some issues with the king safety. I'm sorry, bishop g3, I will just play knight g6. Knight h4 makes sense because queen e2 is the idea. Just trained and play king h7. Now there is, there wasn't rook d5 because I could have just taken twice, and there was queen d3. Just g6. After knight e3, I will play g5. And there is no stopping taking on e4. Maybe. Now, what bishop g6 was unnecessary because now there is queen f3. After that, I would have to play queen e7. Okay, let's limit his pieces even more. Everything is so bad now. Knight's camp. Only rook on one makes some sense, but yes, h3 was an inaccuracy, and after that move, I mean, white couldn't hope for the opening advantage. Let's play the Rosolimo. I'm not really a Rosolimo player, but no doubt it's a very challenging setup for Black. Okay, free and before. Knight f8 looks a bit too slow for me in this position. It's the common idea seen in the system. And to put the knight on e6, but now it's he lost coordination because knight e6 is met by knight d6 check. And his position is very bad. If he would be on time to recapture with knight on c5, then yeah, the knight f8 would be okay. I'll just play c3 d4. One first. Yeah, probably it was better to take on c8 than on f7. There is actually a little sense to capture this knight. Let's see, yeah, obviously much better. Now I'm just aiming to play d5. The good moment, and it would be game over. Okay, d1. He doesn't allow Dao, but now just, I mean, two pawns up should be going pretty straightforwardly, whatever I play, but is there any chance that I checkmate him here? I don't really see. Let's show how to win with two pawns. I mean, okay, I'm just winning on time, so it doesn't really matter, but just to show how such positions are. I mean, how to win such position. So I won on time. Didn't manage to queen. The Evans Gambit. That's a obviously a very romantic opening, but I think there is no edge for a reason here. Now knight a5, I think, is the move. Unless I'm confusing some stuff, but I think the a5 is what they play. d6. Just giving back the pawn on e5, but the idea is that I have good development and better pawn structure, and white doesn't have his usual attack on the king side. So, yeah, but my opponent captured this pawn in a pretty weird manner. Like, usually they recapture it immediately. Now I can get advantage of that and attack his pawn on c3. True, the real the real gambiter wouldn't mind sacrificing his pawn on c3, but yeah, now I think it's not so simple to get an attack with white. What I'm supposed to play now. I'd love to play queen f6, but then pawn c7 would be hanging. Not sure what I'm gonna do after queen c2. Oh, and d5. And there is queen c2 and bishop takes h7 as well. Knight b4 is the move. Yeah, let's play knight b4. Well, it's very risky because there bishop takes h7, knight g5. After that I have to play king g6 and hopefully there is no further attack, but of course I might be missing something. And if I do, I might be lost immediately. Queen f3, maybe queen b3 was interesting to force knight d5, because now I think, I mean, still it's not so easy after the bishop b3, but should be something for black here. Can just play queen f5. After queen g3, there is queen g4 at the very least. Now knight d3. Yeah, knight d3 looks good. After queen g3, I will just take on f4 with the queen. And after queen takes d3, king takes g5. I'm very safe, I think. Knight takes f4. He blundered the rook, but position was hopeless anyway. Just too many pieces were sacrificed. And so that was an interesting game. Probably taking on c3 wasn't that great idea. I mean, at least from the practical viewpoint, because his attack could be very dangerous. I haven't played the London today, so now it's high time. This is an interesting line. Totally forgot about knight f4. Bishop d3 doesn't make any sense. Okay, I have to do something. Now I can display knight h4 and pretend to have some threats. Queen e2. And what I'm supposed to do now? Let's castle queenside. But I'm not sure how I'm going to attack now. Just rook b8 now for black, or e5, e5 also looks good. Let's sacrifice something to... Obviously I miss king g7 now, when there is no queen h5. But still queen g7 is a good response now. But e4 is blundering a pawn, actually two pawns. So now I am in the driver's seat, I guess, even though it's not so clear. Bishop c2, just to keep my king safe. Bishop a2, very greedy. So I'm going to be greedy as well. Yeah, I think he has to take on f5, but this looks like... Yeah, after king e5, just rook e1 check, followed by rook e7 would be enough. Okay, now 3 plus 0, so I have to be a bit quicker. Let's play the... Okay, so another... So Indian, I actually don't have to play bishop b4, I will play d5. c5, what's this? Was this a mouse leap or probably it was. Yeah, quite unfortunate. The b4 move doesn't make things any better for white, to be honest. Now I'm developing with tempi. But there is nothing concrete in seams, so I will just play knight c5 back. Let's trade the light square bishops, because the bishop on e2 is probably one of the best pieces, one of the best pieces in white's camp. Let's see if I've back. Fd8, I guess, or even knight fd7, maybe rook d8. It's actually not as easy as I thought, but again, I've got an extra pawn, so it's just a matter of technique and time. Bishop c1 was forced, otherwise I was going to take on e3, but now I'm both more active and ahead in material. Let's play h6 just to make sure I never blunder any back rank. Checkmate. Queen c2 now is possible. There's no rook c1. Let's just have a. I force trade queens because now. Queen d7, rook takes b2 was game over. Okay, so I will play the last game now. Let's play some very high-rated opponent. Okay, the caro can. Queen e2 is the main move. let's play queen d5 and queen e6. Oh, but queen takes d5 isn't that great for white. I mean, it's probably just a level endgame, but usually people prefer to play against the cards, but which means black pieces now. C4 is not possible. Neither is knight b3 because of b5. So let's just play knight a5 to stop any potential. C4 stuff. Now I'm not sure of this. I can take on g3, but I will just play bishop g6. What I'm supposed to play now? Just play knight c4. And maybe bishop b8 and knight d6. Looks nice. Knight e4. I'm about to start some attack. Not really sure. Okay, now he just blundered the pawn on f2. That's all. King g2 was forced instead of king h2, but then it wouldn't be so easy to actually start some offensive, because after h4 there would be g4 and vice versa after g4 h4. So yeah, but after king h2 it was immediately game over. Okay, so that was the last game. Thank you for your time, for seeing this video, and see you next time.